Happy Thanksgiving, America. I'm Donna, and I'm here with my friends to tell you the real history behind this holiday. Growing up, I knew that what they told you in school about Thanksgiving wasn't true. That's not the true story. The true story behind Thanksgiving was, after every killing of a whole village, these European settlers celebrated it, and they called it Thanksgiving. But it wasn't until Abraham Lincoln became president that it became an official holiday.
He ordered 38 Dakota men to be hung for war crimes.
After the sacred holiday, Christmas.
We take this time to remember our elders who lost their lives due to what really happened. Usually my mom makes a Native American dish for us and we pray.
Growing up, I would be kind of annoyed that they didn't know what actually happened on Thanksgiving and that they're actually celebrating the deaths of many people and many tribes that were lost.
Whether it's to give thanks or to be with your family, you should learn how the holiday was established in the first place.
I'm thankful for being born indigenous to this continent.
I'm thankful that I still have my culture.
I'm thankful that my elders kept our culture alive all these years.
I'm thankful to be indigenous, resilient, and alive.
I'm thankful for us all to be able to stand together, stand strong, and stand as one.
Happy Thanksgiving, America.
Amos chapter 5, verse 21. I hate, I despise your feast days, and I will not smell in your solemn assemblies. Shalom, this is Hawi Allah, called to be a minister of Yahweh Shai HaMashiach by the will of Yahweh, to the church of Yahweh in Babylon the Great and throughout the four corners of the earth, to those that are sanctified in Yahweh Shai and called to be saints, grace and peace and blessings to you from Yahweh our Father and from our Lord and Savior Yahweh Shai HaMashiach. Of course, you've seen, you know, the video of those that are descendants of the original, you know, natives of the tribe of Gad that had met and basically were around the pilgrims that settled, you know, over in the original 13 colonies over on the east coast. And as you know, we are approaching Thanksgiving, which basically is what, you know, I and many other brothers call Thanksgiving. And, you know, one of the things with this type of feast is that, you know, many of our people are celebrating this and they're praying to an unknown God, whoever they perceive in their mind to be God, in the mentality that they're thinking that he is going to accept and he's going to hear their prayers when he's not. Okay, because this is not a feast day that was set up or ordained or given to us, you know, in the law at all. This is not any of the feast days that the Most High gave unto Moses to give to the children of Israel. And that's the reason why when you see these type of things going on, when you see a lot of our people just still not getting it, no matter how many times you tell them, you know, that this is commemorating the slaughter, right, of our people, they still don't want to hear. When you tell them that it's done as a sacrifice and a celebration unto idols, they don't want to hear it. So when you really examine the state and mind of our people, it's really obvious that a lot of our people actually enjoy and love dwelling in their captivity. You know, no matter how many times Jake is talking about, you know, Black Lives Matter or whatever other, you know, movement that they're a part of, or talking about police brutality and things like that, they show that they are down with the slaughter that goes on with their people by celebrating something such as Thanksgiving. No matter how many times they're trying to say, oh, it's a time for our family to be together, you know, it's a time to be thankful for those that are in your life, all that stuff is just the same type of lies that Esau will give you when you ask him why he celebrates it and when you point out the actual history of it. He's going to flip it the same way they do the same thing. So it just goes to show you that, brothers and sisters, this is what you're up against. And I, you know, one of the things I always say is that this is this particular time period, you know, I would say between, you know, November, which is, you know, the Gregorian month, of course, you know, of November all the way to the so-called New Year, is going to be among the toughest times for you younger brothers and sisters in the faith. Because this is the time, especially if you just got into the faith, this is the time when things kick into overdrive. This is when Satan, this is when demons kick into overdrive. And this is where you will truly know that how your family really is, your friends really are. You'll realize that they're for this whole setup, for real. Okay, and you're going to get ostracized. You're going to be, you know, talked down on. You know, everybody's going to look at you like you're crazy. They're going to basically, you know, say, you know, what's gotten into you? You know, why are you angry? How come you're not happy? How come you're not having a jolly old good time? This is the time when they're going to be doing that. You're going to have your coworkers trying to tell you Happy Thanksgiving and all this stuff, you know, and you're just going to be sitting there just, you know, what do you do? Well, guess what you do? You don't participate in what they got going on, okay? And we're going to get to some scriptures into that, you know, because there's been times in the past where guys have said it's okay for you to go and be with your family and eat the food and dwell, you know, be all up in the festivities when that's a lie, okay? So you got to understand what you're standing up for, okay? You're standing up for, you know, your heritage that was gave unto you. Everybody else, whether they be in your family, I don't give a dang if it's your twin brother or your own son or daughter that came out of your loins, okay? They are for this society. They're for rejecting of their heritage that was given unto them, okay? So we're going to continue on. This is Deuteronomy chapter 32 and verse 16. They provoked him to jealousy with strange gods. With abominations provoke they him to anger. They sacrifice unto devils, not to God, not to Yahweh, to gods whom they knew not, to new gods that came newly up, whom your fathers feared not. And that's what they're doing, because that's what's happened in the last days. Our people are actually sacrificing unto gods, unto devils, when they do these meals. When they say they're going to partake in a meal on the fourth Thursday of the so-called month of November, and they're going to call it Thanksgiving, they're going to celebrate it, they're going to pray to a new god, okay, which would be Jesus, also known as Chesaray, not Yahweh Shai, right? Because like we always say, there's a name that comes with a doctrine, okay? That doctrine includes when people are praying and thinking about praying to Jesus, that his worship, the worship for him, includes celebrating things like Thanksgiving, all right, Christmas and New Year's, which are the holidays or the helidays that are coming up, okay? Because there's nothing holy about these days. These are nothing but paganistic days, okay? That's the reason why we have to go into these things, all right? There's a goddess called the goddess of goddess Demeter, who was a pagan Greco-Roman goddess, the goddess of harvest, that is basically being secretly worshipped during these festivities. And the elites of this world, they know exactly what people are celebrating. They know exactly the spirit that they're conjuring up during this particular time of the year. But our people are completely clueless. In fact, for this, they are willingly ignorant. Okay? They're willingly ignorant because when you show them the history, you give them the documentation, you show them these things, they say, you know what, it doesn't matter. I'm not celebrating it for that. But then ask them, why didn't they celebrate it the week before? Why didn't they decide to just hold some kind of a family get-together feast on Friday? Why not on the day before when they all got together? Why not on Sunday before everybody leaves and goes back home? Why not do that? They're not going to do that, okay? They are for this, and this is how you know that. You got to understand, this is the reason why we always say that you cannot save all Israel. You got to first worry about yourself first, and then everybody else that is worthy of actually accepting this. Meaning that if they are willing to hear, they're willing to accept it, you continue moving on with them. But if they're not, you got to keep it moving, because the Most High does not want all of our nation. Most of our nation in this particular captivity, right here, especially in, you know, the U.S., Babylon, what you're going to realize is that they are actually allies to Esau's rulership, because they actually keep this thing going. If our people want to just woke up, if our people just decided, you know what, we're not going to partake in no Thanksgiving, no Christmas, no New Year's, this whole place will crumble down very fast. It will go down immediately, because we're the main ones pushing it. And then they got our people actually out there, you know, playing football games, basketball games, and, you know, having a big old turkey in front of the game and talking about what they're thankful for and all that stuff. They pushed that on us because they have completely, you know, brainwashed our people. But our people really do desire to be like the oppressor. And that's part of the problem. That's why we're going to go ahead and get into this. This is actually 2 Maccabees chapter 4. This is when Antiochus Epiphanes was taken over during the Greek Empire. This is the missing part of the Bible that you do not see. It is called the Apocrypha that was in the Bible for, you know, almost 2,000 years up until about the 1830s, and was taken out by the rulers of this world, which is part of the reason why there's so much confusion about who the Gentiles are in the New Testament. And this is how our people became Gentiles. This is one of the ways. And we're going to kind of just briefly touch on this because it does pertain to this whole, wicked festivity that's going on tomorrow called Thanksgiving. All right, so this is 2 Maccabees chapter 4, verse 14, that the priests had no courage to serve anymore at the altar, but despising the temple and neglecting the sacrifices. Okay, so what sacrifices? The actual sacrifices that they would do. The priests were the ones that were to uphold the law of the Lord that was given unto us. But during this time, because of a wicked man by the name of Jason, who was a Levite, who basically, you know, wanted to have authority in Jerusalem, linked up with Antiochus Epiphanes to bring in Hellenist customs, which included not only their, you know, the language, the style of dress, but the worship of their gods and other customs that they kept as well. Okay, and in this day and age, that would even include things like Thanksgiving. Okay, because what a lot of our people don't understand is that you always had handlers within Israel that the other nations always used over us. Okay, it's the same thing that happens today. That's why a lot of your most famous, jakes that are in this particular society, they'll be the first ones pushing Thanksgiving on you. They'll be the first ones saying Happy Thanksgiving. They'll be the first ones showing their turkeys. And basically, that's what they're going to do. They're going to make everybody else go in that way. But we, again, when you go back into the law, follow not a multitude to do evil. You don't have to do this thing. This is where you really have to show, improve, and say, listen, I'm not going to do this. And especially, you know, you wonder why, if you're of the northern kingdom, and you're among the descendants of the people that lived on this side of the world before these Edomites took over, and you have to explain to your own people why you don't want to celebrate, and they can't get that, you know they're gone. Okay, just because you have the same family, y'all have the same kin, bloodline, you come from the same mother and father and all that stuff, that don't mean that you're of the same spirit. And this is the reason why you're going to have to love Yahweh Shai more than anybody else. Okay? Now continue back on. And neglecting the sacrifices, hasten to be partakers of the unlawful allowance in the place of exercise, after the game of discus called them forth, not setting by the honors of their fathers, but liking the glory of the Grecians best of all. And the glory of the Grecians, which would be, in this day and age, let's just say the glory of the Americans, right? The Edomite American. Right, and the other nations that have been joined against with them, their glory is all these other feasts, which is not found in the Bible. That's just why you can go to any so-called Christian in this society and ask them why they celebrate Thanksgiving. They'll tell you all this stuff about, oh, it's for, you know, thanking God and this, that, and other. They say, okay, where is Thanksgiving in the Bible? Where is this particular feast on? Give me the law in the book of Leviticus or Deuteronomy and show me, or in Exodus, show me where this is, and they can't do it. You ask the same thing about Christmas, they can't do it. You ask the same thing about New Year's, they can't do it. So what are they worshiping? What are they holding the Bible in their hand going to, and saying that they're Christians if they don't even care about this stuff? So that's something you always got to factor in. And a good chunk of our people like the glory of them best of all. They're the first ones to actually push forth and get more excited. They make memes and music about Thanksgiving. You know, I mean, this is what our people are doing. Verse 16, by reasoning whereof sore calamity came upon them, for they had them to be their enemies and avengers, whose customs they followed so earnestly, and unto whom they desired to be like in all things. So these are people that are your enemies. You know this. You know your history. You know what's happened to our people, not only here, but throughout the western side of the world, the western hemisphere, throughout the world. These people have showed that they are nothing more than your enemies as a people. The elites, the people that run this world, and the people that co-sign them, regardless of political standing and party, because they're down with this, they are showing that they're down with the slaughter of your people. They're down with the slavery. They're down with the complete disenfranchisement, the oppression. This is co-signing the oppression. And that's the reason why our people have basically over time have taken on the mind of their oppressor. They want to be like him so bad. They don't want to be like their forefathers. They set aside the honor of our forefathers in the past. So we're going to go into this. This is Proverbs chapter 3 and verse 31. Envy thou not the oppressor and choose none of his ways. That includes don't partake in Thanksgiving. You don't got to do that. You know, I can just tell you from a personal perspective, I stopped even observing Thanksgiving long before I came into the so-called truth, as it's called today. But of course, we know that the truth is really the understanding of the gospel. And I would just leave the house. I told them, listen, not going to eat this food, not observing this day. This day it commemorates the slaughter of the natives of this land, and I'm not going to be down with that. There's other ways you can get around it. If you know somebody else in the truth, you can basically go and kick it with that person if you're in the same city. If not, you know, call a brother that's in the faith. You know, step outside. Walk down the street, you know, get on your cell phone, you know, go inside your room. You don't got to deal with that. Let them do it. Let them do all that stuff, you know, because what our people don't understand is that it ain't worth it to, you know, trim your ways to seek love. You put them to shame by you not doing that. Every year you do it, every year you stand up to that and you say you're not going to do it. It's a sign and token unto them that you are not, that you're standing up for what you believe in, okay? And they're always going to test you every year, because I've seen it every year. Every year they're going to always think that you are just going through a phase. But when they see after year, and they see, yo, this guy's serious. Yo, this girl's serious. She really is not doing this. She is really not going to come over here. She don't give a dang. She is saying she ain't coming. She ain't eating that food. They're going to be like, yo, I need to reconsider. They might start thinking in their mind, and you might win them over through your behavior. All right, so just finishing it off, this is 1 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 18. Behold, Israel, after the flesh, are not they which eat of the sacrifices partakers of the altar? What say I then, that the idol is anything? Or that which is offered is sacrificed to idols is anything. But I say that the things which the Gentiles sacrifice, they sacrifice to devils and not to God. And I would not that ye should have fellowship with devils. That's plain. The things that they're offering, that they're sacrificing, they sacrifice unto devils. Because you got to understand, if your people, all this, you know, all Israel and everybody, listen, if you are You are a Gentile if you're carried out unto dumb idols. If you're still celebrating Thanksgiving, observing it, you are a Gentile according to the New Testament. You are still carried about unto dumb idols. And that's what the people that are that you live with, if they're your family or whoever, that's what they are. That's the reason why. They don't know, they don't truly know that they're sacrificing unto devils, but that's out of their own ignorance. You hope that they will come out of it. You don't gotta, you know, there's a way to handle everything in the right way, as it says in scriptures, if at all possible, be at peace with all men. But this is their mindset. Because you got to remember, Gentiles have their own culture in terms of, you know, as far as in this place would be an American culture, which includes different celebrations. That's why all the holidays in America don't have anything to do with the scriptures. So everything that they celebrate, all those different days that they celebrate, are things that they sacrifice unto devils. Because it's not aligned. The law is spiritual. So if it's not lined up with the law, and it's not lined up with Yahweh, it's lined up with Satan, period. There's no getting around it. Verse 21. Ye cannot drink the cup of the Lord and the cup of devils. Ye cannot be partakers of the Lord's table and the table of devils. Do we provoke the Lord to jealousy? Are we stronger than he? All things are lawful for me, but all things are not expedient. All things are lawful for me, but all things edify not. Okay? So, I mean, that's pretty simple. Yeah, it's lawful for you to eat food on any given day. But guess what? It's not going to be expedient for you to go and sit down and carve a turkey with your family that's celebrating Thanksgiving and eating some, you know, of course, you, because the thing about it, someone would be like, well, look, as long as I don't eat the ham, as long as I don't eat the bacon, I'm good. No. This is your wisdom in the sight of the nations. That's the reason why we were given the understanding of what to do and what not to do. Because that's going to show them that you, that's what partly makes you the light, is that you are showing that this is something that they're not supposed to do. And they will have to ponder and say, you know what, he may be right. But at the end of the day, you're doing this because you want to stand up and fight for the Lord. It's not expedient unto you to partake in something like this. It's just not. This is how you tell the truth, you shame the devil by saying, listen, they ask you, keep it simple. I don't celebrate, I'm not going to celebrate or eat a meal that commemorates the slaughter of the natives. If they don't believe they're Israel, at least say that. Because, you know, you know how our people are. Okay? And if they can't get down with that, then when they boo-hoo and cry about another Jake being slaughtered, then tell them, don't forget, you celebrate Thanksgiving. And that's something that they don't understand. But for you, for your own conscience sake, just don't do it. If you have to ask a question about it, whether or not you should partake in Thanksgiving, whether or not you should be around your family, eat the food, if you have to ask that question, you should already know the answer. So, again, hopefully this is edifying. Again, want to give all praises and glory to our Heavenly Father, Yahweh. And peace and blessings to you, brothers and sisters, throughout the four corners of the earth that are seeking to get out of this wicked, you know, captivity and waiting on the second coming of our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shai HaMashiach. Shalom.